Julius and Ethel Rosenberg will die in the electric chair at Sing Sing prison tonight. Warden Denno said earlier that the executions would begin at 8 p.m. daylight time. That's within the next 15 minutes. We're told that the president and Attorney General Brownell are standing by in the event the Rosenbergs want to make a clean breast of it. Federal Judge Kaufman, who sentenced the couple to death, is still in his chambers to deal with any possible last-minute developments. The execution time was set after the Supreme Court and the president refused to intervene. At noon, the court announced that it had decided to set aside the stay of execution previously ordered by Mr. Justice Douglas. Chief Justice Vinson read the decision for his colleagues Reed, Jackson, Burton, Clark, and Minton. Justices Douglas and Black insisted that the Douglas stay of execution should remain in effect until a closer examination had been made of legal factors. Mr. Justice Frankfurter said that he felt that more time was necessary for counsel on both sides to study and argue what he called the complicated and novel questions raised before the court yesterday. But for the majority, Chief Justice Vinson said, the court does not doubt that Mr. Justice Douglas had the power to issue a stay in the first place. Douglas questioned whether a 1946 Atomic Secrets Act rather than a 1917 Espionage Act applied to the Rosenberg case. He saw this as a substantial question of law. But Chief Justice Vinson said the majority of the court believes no substantial question of law exists. Therefore, the court decided to reverse the Douglas stay of execution. But Douglas, dissenting, said, I know in my heart I am right on the law, and therefore I see my duty. No man or woman, he said, should go to death under an unlawful sentence. And Mr. Justice Black criticized what he called the judicial haste of the court. He said it's particularly out of place where the death sentence is concerned. Black suggested that a less harsh sentence would seem proper because of the conflict between the two laws in question. He also said he had not had the time to consider the legal question involved. After the majority decision was made public, lawyers for the Rosenbergs unsuccessfully sought a new stay and made yet another motion for reconsideration of the case. After this was turned down, the Rosenberg lawyers tried in vain to get Justice Black, Jackson, Burton, and Frankfurter to stay the execution. Then an appeal for clemency was made to the president, and for a second time he said no. Mr. Eisenhower issued a statement which said in part, "By immeasurably increasing the chances of atomic war, the Rosenbergs may have condemned to death tens of millions of innocent people all over the world. The execution of two humans is a grave matter, but even graver is the thought of millions of dead whose deaths may be directly attributable to what these spies have done."